Achette Children's Group presents Reading Champion, Orange Reading Band 6. Read for you by Penny Rawlins and Tom Lawrence. A Crown for Lion by A.H. Benjamin and Jeff Crowther. Reading Champion, Orange Reading Band 6. About the book. Lion wants a crown to show that he is the king of the jungle. He orders the animals to make him a crown, but things keep going wrong. Then sap from the tree drips on Lion and he starts to sneeze. Lion wanted to be a king.
"I need a crown," he said, "so everyone can see that I am a king."
Lion went into the jungle to find someone to make him a crown. Lion saw a monkey up in a tree.
"Monkey," he roared, "I need a crown so everyone can see that I am a king. Make me a crown of leaves."
Monkey got to work. He twisted the leaves and made Lion a crown. But the wind blew it away. Before long, Lion saw Zebra eating her lunch.
"Zebra," roared Lion, "make me a crown of fruit."
So Zebra picked a melon. She put on some berries and made Lion a crown. But it rotted in the hot sun. Then Lion saw Hippo taking a bath in the pool.
"Hippo," roared Lion, "make me a crown of mud."
So Hippo patted and pulled the mud until it looked like a crown. But it started to rain. Lion was sad. He lay down under a tree. Drip, drip. Something was falling onto his nose. Drip, drip. It was sap. It was very sticky, and it was making his nose itch. Lion sneezed.
Achoo!
He sneezed again and again and again.
Achoo! Achoo! Achoo!
His hair stood on end, and then it went hard. Now Lion was happy. He looked like a king. Everyone came to look at Lion's crown.
"I am a king," he roared.
Roar!
Let's have a think about the story. Do you think the other animals like Lion? Why? Or why not? Did you have a favourite part? Which crown do you imagine suits Lion best? What else might Lion like to show he is a king? Perhaps he would like a gown or a throne. Dog at School by Katie Dale and Gustavo Mazzali. Reading Champion, Orange Reading Band 6. About the book. When a dog runs into the school playground and through the school, everyone is worried that Mr. Jones, the head teacher,
will be cross. Then the dog runs straight up to Mr. Jones and gives him a big lick. But Mr. Jones isn't cross at all. It was lunchtime at school. Mr. Jones, the head teacher, was in his office. A dog ran into the playground and took Dan's football. Dan chased him.
Come back, dog, he shouted. Mr. Jones will be cross.
Woof,
barked the dog. The dog ran into the school garden. He jumped on Mr. Potts' flowers. Mr. Potts and Dan chased him.
Come back, dog, they shouted. You are muddy. Mr. Jones will be cross.
Woof, woof,
barked the dog. The dog ran into a classroom. A jar of water went all over Ling's painting. Ling, Mr. Potts and Dan chased him.
Come back, dog, they shouted. You are muddy and soggy. Mr. Jones will be cross.
Woof, woof, woof,
barked the dog. Next, the dog ran into the kitchen. He took some sausages. Miss Jenkins, the dinner lady, Ling, Mr. Potts and Dan chased him.
Come back, dog, they shouted. You are muddy and soggy and cheeky. Mr. Jones will be cross.
Woof, 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 woof,
barked the dog. The dog ran towards the head teacher's office.
Oh no, everyone said.
Mr. Jones came out of his office.
What is all this noise? He shouted.
Woof!
Barked the dog. He jumped up and licked Mr. Jones's face.
He's not my dog, said Mr. Potts.
I didn't bring him to school, said Miss Jenkins. We don't know him, said Ling and Dan.
This is my dog, said Mr. Jones.
He lives in my house.
Spot, what are you doing in school?
Spot went into Mr. Jones's office.
Did you miss me, Spot? Said Mr. Jones.
Woof,
barked Spot. Let's have a think about the story. What do you know about having pets at school? Do dogs usually run through schools? Would you like to have a pet come to your school? Why? Or why not? Why do you think everyone was worried about what Mr. Jones would say? What does this tell you about Mr. Jones? Did you have a favourite part?
Dragon's Hiccups by Jenny Jinks and Martin Remfrey. Reading Champion, Orange Reading Band 6. About the book. Dimpy the dragon has hiccups. She keeps setting fire to everything. Her friends try to help, but nothing seems to work. Then she drinks the water in the sink and starts hiccupping bubbles instead of fire. Dimpy the dragon had the hiccups. Dragon hiccups. every time she went hic, fire came out of her mouth. Dimpy's friends wanted to help her. Everyone went to Dimpy's house for lunch. Dimpy took the chips out of the oven.
Yum!
She said. But then...
Hick!
Went Dimpy. Oh no! Everyone said. So they all went to Sal's house for lunch. Here you are, said Sal, and she gave Dimpy some cake. But then...
Hick!
Went Dimpy. Oh no, said Sal. Hold your breath, said Sal. That will stop the hiccups. Dimpy held her breath. Her face went red. But then...
Hick!
Went Dimpy. Fire came out of her mouth again. Oh no! Said Sal. My table! We can get rid of your hiccups, said her friends. Close your eyes. Dimpy closed her eyes. When she opened them, everyone had gone.
No one wants to be my friend,
she said sadly. Everyone jumped out at Dimpy.
Boo!
They shouted. Dimpy jumped.
Ah!
She cried. But then...
Hick!
Went Dimpy, and fire came out of her mouth. Her friends got out of the way just in time.
It didn't work,
said Dimpy. Dimpy felt sad.
I'm sorry,
she said. You need to drink some water, said her friends. Dimpy ran into the kitchen. She put her head in the sink and gulped down all the water. Every last drop.
Oh, that's better,
Dimpy said. Everyone waited. No hiccups. Everyone looked at Dimpy. They waited and waited.
My hiccups have gone, said Dimpy.
Hooray! Shouted all her friends. But then...
Hick!
Went Dimpy. Let's have a think about the story. What do you know about dragons in stories? What do they usually breathe out? Would you like to have a dragon for a friend? Why or why not? Did you have a favourite part in the story? What do your friends try to help you with? What do you help your friends with?
Fly Home Blue by Penny Dolan and Becky Blake. Reading Champion, Orange Reading Band 6. About the book. Blue, the pigeon, is about to fly in his first race. Tom and Grandad are excited to see whether Blue can find his way home and how far.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.